Hi.
Let's talk about Lucifer.
Let's do it.
Who is he?
Who is he? He's a broken dude. He's a fallen angel. I mean, when I very first read, when I read the first draft, I came in, right, about a week before filming and to do some, you know, just rewrites, and Tom Kapanis, the creator, he had another pilot coming, so he had to go and be on that one. So this one was kind of a lost soul, if you will. So it came and adopted. And what I loved about it is the father-son story of it. And that here's this guy who was the perfect son. He was the most, at least this is the story goes, he was the most loved, he was the most beautiful, the smartest, everything else. And he kind of said, Dad, I want to be worshipped too. Like, you know, Dad built him a throne next to him and said, all right, sit beside me. He's like, all right, then I should be worshipped. And Dad was like, no. I was like, that's hypocritical, Dad. And Dad was like, no, you have to understand that pride is a bad thing, and sent him crashing down to hell. And so I think at this point, he's like, you know, punishment doesn't really work. I've been down here a really long time. I didn't do anything that bad. And he feels rejected. He feels like he lost Dad's love. And all of that I can relate to. You know, I think we can all relate to. You're trying to be... He doesn't want to believe he's all bad. You know? None of us want to believe that. We want to be loved for our broken parts, too. We want to be God and still be accepted. And so he's kind of like a petulant teenager going, Dad, isn't that bad? You know, do I really have to be down here for the rest of eternity? Seems kind of, you know, extensive.
So has he been down here since like the beginning of time, or how long has he been on Earth?
Thousands and thousands of years. I mean, doesn't that seem overkill for a little bit of pride?
So are you guys going to do like a bunch of like flashbacks? Is it going to be in like ancient Rome or?
No. We're going to, although that would be fun, season 7. we're going to really, really ground the show as much as possible. There's been a lot of shows about, you know, Constantine, and, you know, some shows out there that have dealt more with the mythology and the fire and brimstone, demons and monsters. We're trying to examine Lucifer as a human, and as like the biggest, baddest human of all time, trying to figure out if he's got some good in him. Is basically the story. So we're going to keep it on. We're never going to go to hell. We're never going to go to heaven. Never say never. But for right now, we're planning for all those worlds to come to Earth and see how they actually, you know, negotiate their way around humanity.
And what are some of the mythology that you're going to incorporate, like more from what we know of Lucifer, from the comic book? How are you going to play with that?
You know, in talking to DC about it, what we've kind of nailed down is that the show exists somewhere between Sandman and Lucifer, and that at the end of Sandman, Lucifer leaves hell, puts up his wings, and goes and opens a piano bar in Los Angeles, and then a lot more happens. I think it's in the first compilation where the Lux actually burns down, and then all kinds of other stuff happens. We exist before that, so that's where the show exists. Did that answer your question?
And some of the images or the impression that we have from Lucifer, looking at the trailer and stuff, he has a lot of confidence in him. What aspects of his personality do you find appealing that you think viewers are going to resonate with?
His honesty. I think that's, you know, if there were a theme for the whole show, to me it's truth, which is, you know,
he's about embracing your dark side. We hide it, we're embarrassed of it, shame, shame, shame. He's about, you know, what do you desire? Let's not pretend. It's worse to lie. So he never lies, which I love. It's a wish fulfilling in that he says things we always say, you know. So that's probably the most important thing to me about the sound effect is hot.
Last question, guys.
Do you feel comfortable with the format of, you know, procedural or the, I don't know, yeah. What side do you lean towards, more procedural or?
Yeah. Well, you know, having the procedural aspect, it's to me, I look at it like a hanger. You know, you hang the story on it. It's a skeleton. I don't think it's the important or interesting part of the show. I think it just gives us a structure, and then it's all about the character. And, you know, so you might have seen some of the mysteries, of course. We've all seen a million gazillions. You can't do a new client. What do you mean? You can't. I did 5 seasons of CSI Miami. Like, every configuration you can imagine, done. So what's interesting is seeing Lucifer do it. He's not going to play by the rules. He's not going to follow the law. He doesn't have to, like, that person doesn't deserve punishment. That person does. You know, that person, let's say there's some, you know, abused woman who's our criminal. You know, he's going to help her get off. You know, it's justified. Like, it's not about the law for him. So that, to me, is also interesting. It's like Lucifer has his own rules. So the procedural part is very taxing.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you.